Some tasty lunch for the campers.
Ooh, I thought I smelled something.
Why don't you see those back again? before it gets cold.
Sounds good to me.
All right, everyone. Well, I'd like to introduce you to the staff member who I think is the most important. He's our security guard, Captain. Hey. All right, everyone. So we are going to do what is called a reset. We're going to give Captain another opportunity to fly down here. So this isn't newer behavior that he's just learned. So it's not always, you know, it's not always very consistent with him when they first start doing it. So we're gonna give him another opportunity to fly down here. You ready, Mylan? Hey. All right, guys, it doesn't look like he wants to fly down today. That's perfectly okay. Here at Campground Critters, we actually don't make any of our animals do anything that they don't want. But I will tell you a little bit more about Captain, so I'm sure you all got a look at him. He is a Eurasian Eagle Owl. Oh, hey, guys. Oh,
good. You're still out here, Brittany. You know what? There's some shenanigans happening in the bunkhouse. Would you mind checking it out?
Oh, I'll go take care of it.
Thanks. Well, while she's checking that out, I'd like to introduce you to our yellow-headed Amazon parrot. Charlie, can you say hi?
Hi.
That's very polite. You see, he's practicing his songs for the campfire tonight. But he still needs just a little bit of help. He's great at starting the songs, but he tends to forget the last word. Well, wait a second. How would you guys like to help him out?
Sure.
Yeah, all right. So Charlie's going to sing two songs for us. His first song is I've Been Working on the Railroad. So Charlie's going to sing I've Been Working on the Rail, and I need you guys to sing the word road. His second song is an old classic, it's Popeye the Sailor Man. So Charlie's going to sing Popeye the Sailor, and I need you guys to sing the word man. The first word is road, and the second word is man. Why don't we practice first? What's the first word?
Road.
And the second?
Man.
All right, I think we're ready. Charlie, can you sing your first song?
Working on the ranch.
Road.
Nicely done, Charlie. Okay, this next song is his favorite. Can you sing your song about Popeye?
Popeye the Sailor.
Man.
Great job, Charlie. Well, you know what? I think there's some campers at a birthday this month. So why don't you send them all a big birthday wish? Great job, Charlie. I think you'll do great at the campfire tonight. You guys sounded pretty great, too.
Tomorrow?
Campfire, why don't you get those marshmallows ready for tonight?
Ooh, we can do that. Thanks, Mylan.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mylan, and I am the nurse here at camp. And I would like to introduce you to the bird that keeps us in tip-top shape. He's our athletic coach, Rocket. There we go. Hey, buddy. So Rocket is an emu native to Australia and are the second tallest bird in the world. He can grow up to be 6 feet tall, but his tiny wings only max out at 6 inches. Definitely can't fly with those things, but they do help him with balance when he's running speeds of up to 30 miles an hour. Rocket is an omnivore, which means he eats pretty much anything, but his favorite is fruit. He can jump 7 feet and pluck the fruit right from the tree. How about a jump for the audience, buddy? If he isn't able to reach the fruit, what he'll do is use those strong legs of his, hit him up against the truck, and the fruit will fall right on the ground. You feel like jumping today, buddy? Yeah, you do. I know you do. Let's see. There we go. Now, although he isn't able to fly, he's actually a fast runner, high jumper, and a really graceful swimmer. Which reminds me, Rocket, we have a swim meet to get you to. Everyone say bye, Rocket.
Bye, Rocket.
Ooh, don't forget those snacks I packed you. Well, everyone, I like to keep in mind when cooking at camp that snakes are friends and not food. However, my next staff member seems to think a little differently. He is a red-legged sirima from South America. Now, the wild, these guys love to hunt and eat snakes. So he's gonna demonstrate just how that's done with this rubber snake. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my sous chef, Skylar. Now what happens is out in the wild, they'll find the perfect snake, take it, and they pulverize it. Now that may look silly to you, however, it is a useful technique for breaking the bones and tenderizing the meat, which makes for a gourmet meal almost as good as I can make. So let's hear it for Skylar, everyone. Thanks for your help, Skylar.
Sam and Charlie are making a huge mess in the kitchen again.
Oh no, I'll go take care of it. Oh, look, there's Bob. Bob is a messenger pigeon, and he's our mailman here at camp. He's a descendant of the homing pigeon. Homing pigeons were mainly used during both World Wars to deliver crucial messages. We entrusted vital information to these tiny birds, and although flying conditions weren't always ideal and they were hundreds of miles away from home, they always managed to find their way back and deliver their message. Even with all of today's modern science, we still can't figure out how pigeons have such an amazing sense of direction.
Spike!
Sam?
Spike!
You hear that?
Oh, Marlin, have you seen Spike anywhere?
I haven't, but I'll go see if I can find him for you.
Oh, thank you. Spike! Have you guys seen him anywhere? No? He's got a really cute face. He's about this tall. Oh, thank goodness! There you are! Everyone, this is Spike, our nature guide. And an African crested porcupine, which is the largest species of porcupine found anywhere in the world. Now, most people think that porcupines shoot their quills, but that's just a myth. Their quills are actually like our hair, because while they can't fall out, they definitely can't shoot them out. Instead, when Spike feels threatened, he'll flare up those quills and back right up into his enemies. Oh, and Spike, maybe this is why you got lost. You forgot your trail map again. Why don't you head in that bunkhouse and see what those campers want for lunch and get them ready for that nature hike. Thanks for all your help, bud. He's so cute, isn't he? See you later for the night hike. Well, now that you've met most of the staff here at camp, it's time for brain games with the campers. So can I get a volunteer from the back to come out and help lead brain games? Hello, can I get a counselor from the back to come out and help lead brain games? Anybody? Oh. Edward, what are you doing out here? Wait a second. Is this my volunteer? Oh, boy. You know, I'm not so sure about that. You see, you have to be an expert at math. You have to be able to add, subtract, multiply, and even divide. But I guess you did start out here with a lot of confidence. So you know what? Before you leave brain games, I'm going to have to put you to the test first. Brittany. Before you leave, can you grab that barrel? Yeah, the one with the number line on it. We'll use that to give Edward his math test. Oh, and how would you guys like to help us out?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right. So here's how it works. I'm going to call one of you out there for a math problem. I'll then repeat that problem back to Edward just to make sure he completely understands. Then I'll place him right over there on the number line where he'll hopefully knock down the correct answer. Oh, and there is, one more thing. You see, Edward can be a little bit, bird brain. So we have to keep it simple for him. If I call on you for a math problem, be sure that the answer is between 1 and 10. Well, those are all the rules. Who wants to be the first to put Edward to the test? Right there in the orange shirt. 2 plus 2. We're starting with addition, Edward. Your first math problem is 2 plus 2. And no problem at all, he said 4. Okay, well maybe that was just a lucky guess. So let's see if we can go for 2 in a row. Let's see. Do you have one way up top of the blue shirt? 3 plus 3. We're sticking with addition, Edward. Your second math problem is 3 plus 3. And right again. You're doing pretty well here, Edward. So what do you guys think? Should we go for lucky number 3? Yeah? Okay, let's see. Right there in the overall. One plus one. Sticking with addition, Edward. Your third math problem is 1 plus 1.
2 times 5.
But you know what? I don't know about you guys. I'm still not quite convinced. Let's see if we can go for one last math problem. And that'll be 4 in a row, and I'll give you an 8 for the day. So who has his final one way up top? Eight plus one. They're making sure you've got this addition down. Your final math problem is 8 plus 1. Good luck. Could not be trained. But as you can see, Riggs here is a pretty smart pup. There are many animals who are still searching for their forever home, but the Jacksonville Humane Society, and with shelters being critically full, it is our wish the next time you're searching for the new star of your own family, that you check your local animal shelters first. Let's give another round of applause to all of our adopted stars! I'd like to tell you just a little bit more about Starsky. He's one of our beautiful blue and gold macaws. Now, blue and gold macaws are one of 17 species of macaw, all of which are found in South America. And with those beautiful colors comes a pretty incredible beak. He can easily crack open peanuts, walnuts, and even macadamia nut shells. Okay, now as promised, Starsky is going to attempt to break Scout's amazing swing perch record. In order for him to do that, I'm going to place him right over here on this swing. And he has to get it moving back and forth. Back and forth until he gets it high enough to pluck this flower from all the way up there. Okay, Starsky. This is what we've been practicing for. Now remember, back and forth. Back and forth. Back and forth. Lean, really stretch. Back and reach. Lean and really, you guys are all swinging along with them. Okay, back to business. Really stretch. Back. And maybe this time he doesn't have it. But this time he's almost got it. But this time he's got the flower. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that is a new camp record. And at 55 years old, give it up for Starsky. Thank you so much for coming to see us here at Campground Critters. We'd like to invite you to come on up to the front of the stage. Several of our animal stars. And remember, the next time you're searching for the new star of your own family, be sure to check your local animal shelter first. Thanks again, have a great rest of your day.